Hi everyone, this is Joanne Fink from Zenspirations, and I'm still making signs for my friend Riza's wedding with Sakura's Pen Touch Pen. And this one is where they're putting all the place cards, and it's going to say, find your seat. So I figure I can't get into too much trouble just writing the words across. And I'm doing just a normal handwriting that's really widely spaced. But I don't want the Y to go below, so I am doing just a capital Y because I don't have that much space here. Find your, and that doing the S upside down is a trick I learned many years ago from my friend Judy Melvin, that it helps your S stay balanced. Okay, so now that I have find your seat, I'm going to go back and add some weight to the letters, and of course add the heart over the eye because I love hearts and very appropriate for a wedding. So you don't need to do formal calligraphy if you just want to have some snazzy lettering. And having the silver metallic on this beautiful stained wooden background, I think, is really going to pop. So I'm just thickening all the strokes so that they would look pretty much the way they would look if I were doing this with a pointed brush or pointed pen. But it's very easy to do it with any monoline tool like your Micron, or if you're doing the paint pens, the Pen Touch. Pen Touch does come with a calligraphy tip too, but Riza really wants the contemporary style for her wedding signs, and so I am using the monoline tool because that's how you get this effect. Okay. So now I have done find your seat, and I'm just going back to make sure that I have filled in all the little areas that I think ought to be filled in. There's a little hole in my D, and one of the things I like about the Pen Touch is it's opaque, so I can go over it and fill it in, and I don't have to worry long term about the lines. I love how the wood is coming through the letters. That looks so nice. Riza's theme is rustic elegance, and I want the signs to really reflect the beauty of what she's trying to do. Okay, so I think I want a little bit more fluid coming out, so I'm shaking my pen up and down. Hear that rattle? That's a delightful rattle because it means the paint is going to come out a little bit more flowy. And I'm going to add sort of a leaf flourish, since I know Riza likes leaves. And I just did a line, and I'm pulling simple leaf shapes off, and I'm doing I think I'm going to add a little bit onto my F there. So straight line, and then you can add your leaf just like that. And as long as you're filling this space, And then I usually add a little tendril at the edge on both sides to make it look more finished. And if you want, you can go in and color the leaves. And one of the things you'll notice as you're watching is that as the ink dries, well, I'm going to add a little bit more down here too. As the ink dries, it gets a little bit lighter. So now I'm going to add a flourish going the other way. And since Ryza likes leaves, we're making it a leaf flourish. So I did the flourish shape, and I just bring the leaves off of the flourish, straight out, and then put your leaf shape and it's really easy and fun to do. So I hope that if you have a friend who needs wedding signs, you will experiment with the pen touch and have fun lettering. Stay inspired.